Hello and welcome to another screencast review of Backup Exec 2010 R2, a dynamite feature-packed offering from Symantec. We're looking at the main console, and here you have control over both physical and virtual machine jobs, both tape and disk backups, and a news summary to give you a quick view on what is happening on your network and with backup news feeds. One new feature is the in-product renewal assistant that alerts you to when various backup components licenses are up for renewal, as you can see here. This helps solve the pain of handling multiple renewal dates. Setting up the software is very easy and straightforward. Here you see Getting Started menu that will walk you through any pre-installation tasks and links to the documentation. The install process has been streamlined and make the most decisions for you. You can roll back the upgrade if you get into trouble, and there are plenty of reports to choose from as well. Backup Exec 2010 R2 Edition includes support for new clients and servers, including Mac and Linux systems, and new are support for SharePoint, Exchange, and SQL Server. Symantec has expanded its granular recovery technology to make single-pass backups more powerful. Now you can recover both the full image as well as extract a single user account from an Active Directory store, a single email message from an Exchange mailbox, a document from a SharePoint repository, and a data record from a SQL database. You can even extract emails and AD objects from within VM backups too. Symantec has also integrated its deduplication technology into Backup Exec 2010. For organizations with growing data, this means lower cost and fewer hassles. As you can see in the video, we save 82% of the storage from earlier backup jobs. You have the option to run your deduplication at the source of the data, the client machine, or at the media server, depending on where you have extra computing resources. A second improvement is to the virtual machine protection features. Earlier versions had to stage their VM backups. Now it can be done in a single pass using the SAN infrastructure itself and with better incremental backup performance and accuracy. There is support for vSphere, vStorage APIs, and Hyper-V, including vMotion and live migration features to move VMs from one server to another. Here we see the expanded properties and features under the VMware options, such as the ability to use GRT, dynamically identify and include new virtual machines, and even backup powered off VMs. The third set of features includes integrated archiving options to save storage space and speed up your backups. Here we have archived some specific files and we're retrieving them using the web interface. You can archive unused data off your primary disks and move them to secondary disk storage or eventually to tape. What are things that are missing? While the integrated dedupe is nice, for multiple site backups you will need additional licenses and agents, and some server features require running Backup Exec 2010 R2 on 64-bit servers. Backup Exec 2010 R2 improves overall end-user experience through faster installs, new platform support, and improved recovery times. Thanks for watching this screencast. You can view more of them at webinformant.tv. Get information about my speaking business and links to my other articles here.